Okay, we have a ThinkBook. Apparently it receives 20 volts, but it does not charge. Okay, 14SG ITL. You know what I like about this? Like this? Like a book, you open it? There we go. Somehow it's a Lenovo. It's the other way. Okay, let's see. Power. It does power on. Lenovo logo. So what's the issue? Oh, it does power on. But it does not charge, okay. Type C. Okay, what could it be? Interesting. Let's see if 20 volts actually goes into the system or not. Does the battery get charged? No. That's good. The power is coming in, so it does turn on, I guess. Could be just the battery, eh? No, current is not coming in. Current is not coming in, that's so odd. Okay. Lenovo resorted to using kitchen foil. the spaghetti design, okay. So, what's wrong with you? Where did it start? Let's check. So there's some foods here. So it's brown. And another one here. Okay. Let's look for type C. There's an inductor here. The MOSFET there. Let's just have a quick look around there and then we'll look at the schematics or board view. That's the firmware for the Thunderbolt probably. Dual MOSFETs. Yeah, they utilize two dual MOSFETs. Okay, they're in the kilo ohms range, and this guy. A bit higher than the other one, but this one seems better, this one does not. So these guys are gonna be fine. Yep, this guy is also fine. It's fine. Okay. AT25-7, that's the BQ chip, BQ25-7-10. And the other side, anything interesting? Even though they said the port is fine, is it really fine? Let's have a look. Yeah, that does look good. Hello, SureCan speaking.
Hi, this is...
Alright, okay, power tester. Thank you. So what we're interested in is, I think it is VCC lines to ground. Huh, that's good. That's good. That's good. That's all good. How about the data lines? Why did we get all the interesting? Okay, let's have a look, see if we got any schematics to work with. 20, 3008-2. We do have something. Okay, we have to make do with what we got again. So that's where the communication happens before it's passed on to probably. Okay, what have we got here? Yeah. So it communicates through here. Probably it's going to be a connection to here. Let's see if there's a problem here. That's a capacitor too, eh? We're in diode mode. Yeah, to ground. The V-bus looks okay. 20 volt wire. DC in, power delivery, DC in. maybe here. Yep, to the ground. Okay. Okay, let's have a look at battery. Power charge, battery. Is the bat out? AC in. So there is no short on the main power rail. Does 20 volts come in here? Let's check. See, so there's a point of failure before that, so why isn't it coming here, there? Okay, see if it's coming here. No, so it's not coming here either. So let's go back to, what's this guy? Okay, let's check him, which is where. So there's nothing here actually. WC power. Okay, that's it. All right. One sec, gotta send in this. All right, let's continue looking. So we're checking here. What is this? Ground. Enable RN, what is this? I have no idea where are these going to. But that's the one we're interested in. Okay, let's go here. So 20 volt comes to the point of charger, like maybe the protection circuit just before. It's cutting out somewhere. Check out here. So we do get it up to here. It's gonna be ground. It's coming from this chip. This chip is not giving it. Is there 5 volts? lights here. No, I'm looking at the wrong chip. Wait. Yeah, I'm looking at the wrong chip. Should be this one. So we don't even have 5 volts there. Go back here. Damn it, did I miss it? Okay, let's go back. Here. Going to here. Going on top of that. Which was that one, correct? What is that? It's a fuse. TB, TB, V-bus, okay. Keep going back here. 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 So we don't have anything there. Power enable. So that's probably off. Oh, that is. Oh, okay. So that's RTB power enable. Okay. How about that? Yeah? Is there something missing there? The gateway bus is there. How about these LDOs? Okay, so these are before it. Alright, so I'm thinking of, what's this one? Intel, okay. Yeah, I'm thinking of replacing this guy. Because power is not coming out. Here. Why are we getting 20 volts? Where else is it supposed to be coming from? Let's check him out. Let's go back to the other side. We are on the other side. I feel like there was a chip here, it's missing. How come? Yeah, definitely. What the hell was here? U4201. How the hell do I know where you are? And volts. These are 20. 20. 20. 1.5. Our track stops here. The buck stops here. Why? Okay, so what we'll do, right, we'll go online, have a look at motherboards, which... Oh, how is this missing? Is it supposed to be missing? Yeah, right, Google. Does this have two RAM slots? No, this has no RAM slots. Yeah, really.
way. Turn back here.
Okay, so the area we're interested in is U42. GP, I think they usually mean it's not there. Yeah, I'm thinking of bridging it, which may be a bad idea. Who's there is... I think that was good, no problem. Okay. Who's is no problem, who's the ground? Is no problem. So, my question is, what will happen if we connect those two together? Whichever one gets first is higher, gate 1, gate 2 passes through. Where the hell am I gonna find it? CSA 8750. Dual common drain and channel master. It's missing here. That's why, I mean, we can run a wire. I don't think there will be a problem, but that is not the right thing to do. Maybe these guys are bad. Let's check them out. What's the resistance of this guy? Should be 100 ohms, yeah? That's per sheet. Yeah, that's fine. And that's the other one. Yeah, makes sense. You know what? Let me just go back to voltage. Plug that back in. Yeah, we still don't have it. I'm tempted to plug it in. Let me rotate the connection around. No, same. Alright, will it kill? Let's do it anyway, which is a bad idea. We're bridging a MOSFET. Well, there is no MOSFET. Too hot. There we go. Bad, okay. Something's gonna burn. There we go, now we got consumption. Yeah. So what's the issue with this way of doing it? There's a component missing there, I don't know why. I will charge a battery. I don't know if it will even charge a battery. Oh. That explains a lot. Wow, we're spot on. Look at that. The chip is actually there. Oh, that's so funny. Okay, yeah, he's burned to bits. Yeah. Will it still work? I doubt it. I mean, we just needed to simply access a wire, really. Continuity. That's fine. That's fine. But shouldn't be connected there. Good. Okay, not yet. How about here? No. Okay, so this may work. I don't know. Shall we try it? Let's put it back in there. What happened? It couldn't resist the heat and just went kaput. Damn it. Here it is. Ah, oh, right, I broke it again. Now, what will happen if you connect this? Let me have a think about it. I don't know if it will kill the battery or not. So this guy connects, as we know, here, there, there, tracing back to how did we get there anyway? Through here, there, bottom, yeah, okay. Now where is this one going? Top? Here? Ah, okay, okay, okay. So if you go back, so the other one is battery, see? Basically, okay, so, you won't allow the battery to power up the system, or will affect that functionality. I think we'll get this chip replaced. Okay. Alright, I'll find the chip and that will be the end of this video. It will make a part 2 later on if I find it. Otherwise, see you in the next one.